Hey everybody, what's going on? This is a special edition, we'll call it a bonus episode of Martial Arts Radio. I'm recording this on March 23rd. It's a Monday. We just put out an episode today, but the world has been changing so rapidly. And honestly, I've been agonizing with how to handle this. What do we do? What do we say? What do we talk about? People have been reaching out to me personally and professionally. And in order to tell you why this is a special episode, let me just give you a little bit of insight. We try to keep a buffer of episodes. We might record an episode and it might go into post-production and take weeks before it actually comes live. And that makes our process a lot easier. But the downside of that is that if something specific comes up, not that it happens often, but something like this, we can't really act unless we undo a bunch of work and have to redo it. And not that this wouldn't warrant that, but I thought it made more sense instead of canceling other content and delaying things and having to redo work, I thought, let's just make another episode. Now, actually, after I'm done with this one, I'm going to be recording a second episode. This episode here is for individuals, for practitioners of the martial arts. The other episode I'm going to do will be for school owners, because we do a fair amount of consulting with martial arts school owners. And instead of saying the same things that I've been saying to a lot of people, I figured let's put it all out there for everybody and do what we can for the industry. So you can look for that episode. But let's get into this. Let's talk about what's going on and what it's like to be a martial artist in the time of the coronavirus. Most of your schools are closed. You're not going to formal classes. Maybe you're doing some one-on-one stuff. I'm seeing a little bit of that still going on. But for the most part, to my knowledge, there are very, very few martial arts classes. So if that's the case, just as an aside, this is the tough part about video. I don't get to go back and edit it. As an aside, I already said that. Man, this is also the problem with me recording at 9:15 at night. 3, 2, 1. There's a good chance that this is you. Statistically, this is you. Your classes have been canceled. So what do you do? Well, I see a lot of schools putting out classes over video, and hopefully you're doing those. Hopefully you're supporting your martial arts schools in whatever way works and makes sense for you, wherever you're at, financially and such right now. But regardless, there's more. There's a lot more. And I've got a whole page of more of what we're offering, what you can do. And with the exception of one line item I've got here, it's all free. So first off, don't forget that there are plenty of other options. I'm not just saying that you have to check out what we've got. There are a ton of podcasts out there. We're going to talk about our podcast in a moment, which you already know about, most likely, because you're watching an episode or listening to an episode of the show. But we have martialartspodcast.com with a bunch of other shows available on there. And we try to promote whatever's going on in the industry. If people have a martial arts podcast, we try to talk about it. And if there's a show that's missing, reach out to the host. Let's get it submitted so we can put it up there. Here are a whole bunch of ways you can further being a martial artist. Because remember, being a martial artist isn't just going to class. It's not putting on a uniform. It's not doing drills. It's not being in that formal environment. Being a martial artist is a 24/7 identity. It's who you are and how you act and who you show up for, and all of those qualities that we develop as martial artists and the way we utilize them in and out of training. So, first thing you can do, you can work on your weaknesses. How many times have we heard our instructors say, you know, you got to work on this at home. You got to work on this at home. Well, if you're not going to classes, you've got time. Hopefully you have time. There are some of you out there, maybe you work in the medical field. You might not have time, but most of us have more time right now. So this is an opportunity to work on those weaknesses, and you know what they are. Now, in terms of specific things to work on, I just sat down, identified a number of episodes. I'm going to go over them really quickly. And we added a special section to the podcast website, whistlekickmartialartsradio.com. You'll see up at the top, Quarantine Toolkit. That seemed to be the best thing to call it. And all these episodes I'm going to mention here are easily available from there. The first one, basics. We did a whole episode number 205 on basics and drills that you can do mostly on your own regarding basics. Forms 162, you might call them kata or pumse or something else. But we did a whole episode on drills, again, mostly for yourself, with 162. 125 was sparring. And while a lot of the drills in there may involve someone else, not all of them do. There are plenty of things you can do to get better. So whatever your weakness is or whatever you want to get better at, bam, here's four more. Practicing on your own, number 375. Developing speed, 203. Conditioning, 56. And watch very soon, hopefully by the end of this week, we will have our strength and conditioning program ready to go. The beta is out. People are checking it out. I've got them digging through. I really want to get this out this week because I'm sure plenty of people are looking for something like that. And then instincts, 54. There's an old episode, but still a really good one. I remember a lot about that episode. So there are 7 episodes that you can check out specifically tied to things that you can train. Now, the next category of stuff I'm calling edutainment. Education, entertainment, kind of an intersection of the two. There are plenty of ways that you can get some value. For Martial Arts Radio, we have almost 500 episodes, 486 episodes as of today. They're all available for free at whistlekickmartialartsradio.com, and they should be available on YouTube. They are available on YouTube. And every podcast player you could think of should have them available. So check those out. We also have First Cup, 420 episodes. If you're not familiar with First Cup, it's a show that I do weekday mornings. It's my first cup of coffee, wearing a bathrobe, responding to questions and comments. Some of that stuff is related to what's going on currently, but if nothing else, it's more stuff. It's more conversation about martial arts, and regardless of the topic that comes up, I try to bring it back to martial arts. Books. This is the one thing that costs money. We've got half a dozen, plenty more coming. And if you check out the majority of the books, we sell them at the minimum price Amazon lets us sell them at. In fact, we would sell most of them for free, sell them for free if they let us. Most of the Kindle books are 99 cents. Most of the paperbacks are $3.58. Excuse me, because Amazon won't let us go lower. The Facebook group, Martial Arts Fun and Friends. We launched that a couple months ago, and it's been growing. There are hundreds of members in there. See a few more come in every day. And it's a politics-free, positive, no promotion Facebook group to talk about martial arts, get advice, post funny things. And it's been a real fun distraction from a lot of what's going on. And then a couple more things that we don't talk about very often. Master Hopkick, our mascot, the rabbit, who we really haven't put a lot of resources into because we've been focused on other things. MasterHopkick.com, you'll find a free coloring and activity book that you can download and print out. We did that a couple years ago and it's still there. So check that out. And then finally, on the edutainment front, Martial Journal. That's MartialJournal.com. That site's been running for a couple years now. There's a ton of content up there. Some of it is, we might call stale, but most of it in the industry, we call it evergreen, right? So it's just as relevant now as it was when it was written. So you can check out plenty of articles, a lot of stuff on books and movies, TV shows, and a lot of the stuff up there is great. And what I love about Martial Journal is no one gets paid. It's an entirely volunteer organization. There is a little bit of money that has to happen, and we cover all those costs. And then the last thing, the thing that I think we're all doing pretty well right now, is connecting with others. This whole being inside and limited social contact is really tough. And regardless of how you're handling it, reach out to others. Reach out to your training partners, your martial arts friends. How are they doing? Find opportunities, if not to train, just to connect. You might be handling this really well, but don't overestimate how well others are handling it. This is a tough time for everybody, and let's make sure that we mitigate these challenges, right? Use what you know of martial arts, part of what we know of martial arts is supporting others, being there for other people, protecting them from what may harm them. And what might be harming people right now is that isolation. So don't be afraid to reach out, whether it's by phone, by social media, by Skype, FaceTime, Zoom, I don't care what it is, but make sure you're talking to other people, you're connecting with them for your own mental health and for theirs. So on the off chance someone shared this episode and you're not familiar with Whistlekick and what we do, you can find everything we've got going at whistlekick.com. Our podcast is whistlekickmartialartsradio.com. And yeah, there you go. So thanks for watching or listening. Thanks for your support. I'm doing okay. Honestly, my life hasn't changed that much. I live alone. I live in the woods. So the isolation thing's pretty easy for me. But I've been spending a lot of time talking with a lot of people. And I'm going to hang this up now. And I'm going to go do the episode for the school owners. So until next time, train hard, smile, and have a great day.